Let's quickly understand what is the feed line or Q line in the McCabe Thiele method and how its slope changes for different feed conditions. So, the Q line or feed line represents the feed condition. In simple word, Q line represents how much of the feed entering the column is liquid and how much is vapor. So on the McCabe Thiele diagram, Q line is the line that connects the rectifying section and stripping section operating lines. And its slope depends on the feed condition. The general equation for the feed line is Y is equal to Q divided by Q minus 1 into X minus ZF divided by Q minus 1. And the slope of this feed line is Q divided by Q minus 1. Now, based on the value of Q, the line changes its slope and direction. So let's quickly see how the slope of the Q line changes for different feed conditions. So let's start with the saturated liquid feed. In this case, the feed entering the column is completely liquid, so we need to add heat to vaporize a part of it before separation can begin. Here, Q is equal to 1, and that makes the slope infinite. So, when we draw this on the McCabe Thiele diagram, we get a vertical line, that's the Q line for a saturated liquid feed. Next, if the feed is partially vaporized, that means it's a mixture of liquid and vapor, not fully one or the other. Here, the value of Q is between 0 and 1. The slope in this case is positive, but less than 1, so it appears as a gentle upward sloping line. This line tells us the feed is partly liquid and partly vapor. Now, if the feed is a saturated vapor, that means it's entirely vapor, so there's no need to add heat at the feed point. For this condition, Q is equal to 0 and the slope becomes 0. That means the Q line is horizontal on the diagram. If the feed is a subcooled liquid, that means it's colder than its boiling point, so it needs extra heat before vaporization. Here, Q is greater than 1, and the slope is greater than 1, giving us a steep upward line on the diagram. And finally, if the feed is a superheated vapor, that means it's hotter than its dew point, so instead of absorbing heat, it actually releases heat to the column. In this case, Q is less than 0, and the slope becomes negative, so the Q line slopes downward. Therefore, as the feed condition changes from liquid to vapor, the Q line tilts from steep upward to horizontal, and then downward. Which shows how the energy condition of the feed affects the column's operation. So, that's all about the feed line, or Q line.